diseases of jute. Now you'll see the important diseases that can affect jute. So scientific name of jute is Carchorus capsularis. My name is N. H. Shankar Reddy and I am doing PhD plant pathology in Allamala University. So these are all the list of important diseases in jute. Root rot or stem rot caused by Macrophomina fasciolina, powdery mildew caused by Iodium species, anthracnose caused by Coltrodricum carporum, stem gall caused by Pisoderma carpori, and dieback caused by Diplodia carpori, wilt caused by Rhizoctonia solani, bacterial leaf spot caused by Xanthomonas campestris pathovar, Necati carpori, and bacterial wilt which is caused by Pseudomonas solanacearum, little leaf or bunchet up which is a phytoplasmal disease. So now we will see in detail about one by one. The first one is root rot and stem rot. So which is caused by Macrophomina fasciolina. Coming to young seedlings, we can see thin streaks and at collar region can also be can seen on the cotyledon, especially we can see here. Thin streaks can be seen on the collar region, especially here. Thin streaks can be seen on collar region. Later what will happen during favorable conditions, the small streaks will start to enlarge and kill the seedlings at initial stage. So high humidity will highly favors for this Microphomina fasciolina, and this disease will spread very rapidly and is often called as damping off disease. So bark shredding also can be observed here. We can see, stem shredding can be seen here. When we seen on grown up plants, so black color lesions on the leaves, and also the same black color lesions also seen on the margins and as well as midribs, petioles can be seen. And this Macrophomina fasciolina will produce sclerotia, minute black color sclerotia can be on the characteristic symptom. Resting spores, we can see the black color minute sclerotia that is produced by Macrophomina fasciolina. Coming to the management practices, field sanitation and balanced application of fertilizers can be recommended along with the burning of crop debris and spraying of dithane M45. Dithane M45 is the trade name of mancozib. So spraying mancozib at the rate of 18.56 gram per 10 liter of water can be recommended along with spraying mancozib or manner M45 at the rate of 2 gram per liter of water can be recommended for 2 to 3 times at the application to the soil base. So coming to the next disease, powdery mildew, which is caused by Iodium species. We can clearly see white color ashy powdery growth. White color powdery growth can be seen on the lower surface of leaves. Make sure the white color powdery growth can be seen on the lower surface of leaves. Later this white color powdery growth, later the leaf slowly starts to turn into brown color and later stages they will wither. So this powdery mildew infected jute plants are having a poor fiber quality as well as they are very weak because of this powdery production, and they'll slowly weakens the plant. So coming to anthracnose. So anthracnose, which is caused by Coltrodricum carporum. So coming to the symptoms, we can see here yellowish brown color water soaked lesions can be seen here initially. Yellowish brown color water soaked lesions with the depressed spots can be seen. Later the same spots are converted into brown in color and later stages black in color. Initially they are water soaked lesions, yellowish water soaked lesions that then they convert into dark brown in color, and finally they can see the black in color. Then here this several spots which produce the different types of several spots on stem region, and the several spots are coilages, and if you see the distance we can it produce a large patches and griddling of stem can be seen. So in the severe stages necrotic lesions can be produced on the pods, and in the severe stages entire plant will die, and it's a very economical losses for farmers. So coming to management aspects, seed treatment with Provaxin 200 at the rate of 4 gram per liter of per 1 kg of seeds 4 gram per kilogram of seeds can be recommended, along with crop rotation with rice and wheat also are recommended. Next disease is stem gall, which is caused by Pisoderma carpori. The name itself indicates galls are formed in stem regions. So initially this disease, we can see this at the height of 8 to 10 centimeter. Let us consider this is jute plant. We can see this formation of galls at 8 to 10 centimeter above the root level. So here and the greenish galls are observed on the lower portion of the stem, and as well as the main symptoms are can be observed at 8 to 10 inches of high, and it produces small small galls or small tumors. Initially they are very small in size, later they turns when the maturity happens, the very the small gall can be converted into very big in size. We can see here, so this galls contains a huge number of spores, sporangiospores. So coming to the dieback, which is caused by Diplodia carcori, name itself indicates dying of plants or dying of leaves, we can see here. So here initially the discoloration of the main shoots can be seen, and along with the darkening and withering of branches. So slowly, first of all, the leaves starts to discoloration, in the sense initially the leaves are green in color, they slowly starts to convert into yellow in color, or different types of colors can be seen. And later stages, in the darkening and withering of the branches can be seen. Ultimately, we can see the blackening of stalks. And here we can see the pycnia of and infected spore masses and pycnia can be seen here in the infected parts. Coming to the management aspects, two sprays of Dithane M45, that is Mancozib M45, at the rate of 18.56 grams in 10 liters of water can be recommended at 2 to 3 days interval, in between. And crop rotation with Deshi jute instead of Tosa or and some other varieties, and spraying with Dithane M45 and Manor M45 at the rate of 2 gram per liter of water for 2 to 3 times can be recommended. So the next disease is wilting. So wilting, which is caused by Rhizoctonia solani. So coming to the symptoms, initially wilting can be mainly observed in the root system, especially in jute. In root region, we can see this infection of wilting. So which is because Fusarium is Rhizoctonia is a soil-borne pathogen. So here, if you see this leaves are flaxseed, and the drooping of leaves can be seen. Flaxseed and drooping of leaves can be seen, at especially during flowering stage. The infection will be very severe, especially during flowering stage, and this can be disseminated by seed and as well as soil. So coming to the management aspects, so removing of crop debris will be destroyed or burned, and along with the crop rotation will maintained with other capsularis varieties, rather than cultivating the same jute cultivars, better to go with other cultivars also. And spraying of Dithane M45 or Manor M45 at the rate of 18.56 gram per 10 liter of water can be recommended. So bacterial leaf spot, which is caused by Xanthomonas campestris pathover necetacarcori. This is a causal organism. Coming to the leaves, we can clearly see here, initially green color spots are appears here. Initially green color, small green color spots are appear. Later this green color spots are converted into brown in color. So this small spots are coalesces. Later stages we can see here, initially there are small spots can be seen here. In the later stages we can see here, these small spots are coalesces and they form very big necrotic areas. Later stages they form very big necrotic areas, which slowly converted into yellow in color, and drooping of leaves also can be observed here. So here the spots are circular in color, which are brown in color, later they convert into yellow in color. The sunken lesions are developed on the capsules. If you see on the capsule, we can see the sunken lesions. So these lesions are in later stages of development. If we see in detail, or if we magnify it, we can see the stem is surrounded by yellow border that can leads to sometimes a death of the plant above the infection plant pots. So coming to the next one, bacterial wilt, which is caused by Pseudomonas solanaceatum. Coming to the symptoms, the affected plants are stunted and become chlorotic. So here the root system of the plant, especially here the root system of the plants, in the serious deterioration of the symptoms can be observed. Serious deterioration can be observed, especially in the root regions. So the causal agent is a bacteria, you will know very well, which is a gram positive bacteria, which is a problematic in especially solanaceous crops. So coming to the management aspects, avoiding movement of infected plants or soil from infected area to uninfected areas. And jute should not be planted or crop rotated or crop rotation with susceptible and solanaceous crop plants, because solanaceous crops also highly susceptible. So it is not planted or crop rotated with susceptible or solanaceous crop plants. Coming to the next one, little leaf and bunchy top. So which is a phytoplasmal disease. Coming to the symptoms, So infected plant shows profuse tellering and as well as branching of bushy branching can be seen. Profuse tellering and bushy branching can be seen on infected plant parts. So if you see the apical, branching at the apical portion are developed like bunchy top symptoms, which are tufts of smaller leaves can be seen. So bunchy top in the sense bunch of leaves can be seen with the tufts of tufts in the sense a number of very small, a bunch of leaves can be formed in the same area. Together in the same area, that is called bunchy appearance. So while we're discussing about the banana, there is a disease called banana bunchy top. In there we will see in detail about what is bunchy top and what are the symptoms of bunchy top. Coming to the questions related to ARS or NET, there is nothing much to look into except causal organisms. Remember the causal organisms of diseases. So this is about Jute.